She's now in her 90s. And even though she has slowed down a bit since the first time I met her some 30 years ago, while she was in her 60s, why, she has not lost one bit of her feistiness, her free-spiritedness. It's what I love most about her. I met her when I was in the seminary, and while I was at my teaching parish, she had been assigned to the group that was in charge of making sure that they would observe me and the ministry that I was doing as a seminarian in the parish, and then they would give me, well, they would give me feedback once a month. And she was part of that group. Well, I never, ever, ever had to wonder what she was thinking. You know, she's one of those kind of people. Perhaps you know somebody like that. Maybe you are somebody like that. What I want to tell you is I love people like that. It's nice not to have to wonder what people are thinking, that they are willing to be able to express themselves clearly, and even though it might be their opinion, nonetheless, you know where it is they stand. This is that kind of lady. Now in her 90s, I think of her every year as we celebrate this feast of the presentation of the Lord, because if I were to put a face on Anna, who is in today's gospel, the prophetess, why, I would put that lady's face right smack dab there. She is the Anna in my life. Because she recognized the Messiah. But there's something about this woman in her 90s that I have most appreciated. And she's always said to me, her mantra, her motto that she lives by is quite simply this: Father Steve, God has never lived up to my expectations. That's her motto. God has never lived up to my expectations. I said, really? And even when I visited with her over the Christmas holidays, over the phone, and why, she reminded me of that again. Father Steve, God has still not lived up to my expectations. But I remember the first time she said that, it kind of struck me as odd. How about you? You probably felt the same way when I just said it. But then she would go on to say, sometimes God has exceeded my expectations. But most of the time, God transforms my expectations. God has never lived up to my expectations. God has transformed them. That's why I think of her on this feast of the presentation of the Lord. Because we have two elderly people, Simeon and Anna. Both of them believed at the very depths of their being that they would have the opportunity to witness and to see the Messiah before God would call them home. And they both believed to their very core that this would happen, but something tells me both Simeon and Anna were not expecting the Messiah and that expectation of theirs to be fulfilled through an infant. Do you think so? I don't think so. I'm thinking Simeon and Anna had been around the block enough times that they probably figured, you know, God, the Messiah is going to come with such great splendor and power that you're never going to miss it. And yet, their expectations, Simeon and Anna's, were transformed. And how were they transformed? Well, we have that beautiful image, an image that we can all relate to because we've all had the experience. And what does Simeon do as Mary and Joseph bring the child Jesus into the temple? What does Simeon do but, well, he takes the infant into his arms. You know what that feels like, don't you? You know what it does to you when you hold an infant in your arms. You become completely different. We all do. Think about it. You become crazy people when you have an infant in your arms. You start making noises to the infant. You do all those things because what has happened? Well, what has happened is this infant transforms your heart. And that's what happened to Simeon. And that's what happened to Anna. Something tells me that day in the temple, as Simeon took this infant into his arms, and as that infant looked up into Simeon's eyes, why, Simeon then knew that his own eyes had finally seen what he believed would happen before he would die. Now, Master, you can let your servant go in peace, for indeed my own eyes have seen the salvation of Israel and a light to the Gentiles. Yes, Simeon's heart had been transformed. But in order for that to happen, what did Simeon have to do? He had to take the child into his arms, and in holding the infant in his arms, he took mystery and he held it next to his heart. He held mystery next to his heart. Because that, my friends, is what you and I need to do likewise on this feast of the presentation of the Lord. We need to be mindful of the fact of the beautiful message and wisdom of this elderly woman who says, our expectations have never been met by God. They've been transformed. Because so oftentimes, our expectations when it comes to God is that God visits us in certain places, at certain times, in certain circumstances, and through certain people. And so we confine God and our expectations of God to a very narrow and small box. We're all guilty of it. But on this feast of the presentation of the Lord, we are invited to be open to the gift of mystery. A mystery that invites you and I to recognize that all those expectations that we have of God, why, they are not only exceeded, but most importantly, they are transformed. They're changed right before our very eyes if we just take the infant each and every day into our arms and hold that mystery close to our hearts, because like any infant in our arms will do in this life, it will change us. It will make us full of life and love. So we enter the temple and we look for the Messiah, and we discover that he's found today in an infant who in a few moments will be baptized. And we take this infant as a community of believers and we hold this infant up to the Lord, and our expectations, they're transformed. As we prepare to celebrate Callie's baptism, let us invoke the saints of our God in heaven, that through their intercession they might continue to inspire us and to help us walk in the footsteps of Christ. To each of these saints' names, our response will be, pray for us. Holy Mary, Mother of God. Saint John the Baptist. Saint Joseph. Saint Peter and Saint Paul. Saint Catherine. Saint Teresa. Saint Francis, all holy men and women. Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, you sent your only Son into the world to cast out the power of Satan's spirit of evil, to rescue us from the kingdom of darkness, to bring us into the splendor of your kingdom of light. We now pray for Callie Marie, set her free from the original sin. Make her a temple of your glory, and send your Holy Spirit to dwell with her. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Callie, we anoint you with the oil of salvation in the name of Christ our Savior. May he strengthen you with his power, for he lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. I would invite the assembly to please stand. Let us join our voices together as we renew our baptismal promises, rededicating ourselves as disciples and followers of Christ. Parents and godparents, I invite you to state these promises on Callie Marie's behalf this first time. So to each of these questions, we respond, I do. Do you renounce sin so as to live in the freedom of the children of God? Do you renounce the lure of evil so that sin may have no mastery over you? Do you renounce Satan, the author and the prince of sin? Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? This is our faith. This is the faith of the Church, and we are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Amen. Troy and Kayla, is it your will then that Callie Marie be baptized in the faith of the Church which we have all professed here with you? If so, please respond, it is. And invite the assembly to please be seated as we baptize Kaylee today. Callie Marie, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We now anoint Callie with the oil of chrism, as Christ himself was anointed priest, prophet, and king. So through this chrism oil, she is christened and is made one in Christ. And so we pray, God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, has freed you from sin, given you a new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and has welcomed you into his holy people. Callie, he now anoints you with the chrism of salvation, as Christ was anointed priest, prophet, and king. So may you live always as a member of his body, sharing everlasting life. Amen. Callie Marie, you have become a new creation and you've clothed yourself in Christ. See in this white garment the outward sign of your Christian dignity, with family and friends to help you by word and example bring that dignity unstained into the everlasting life of heaven. Amen. Callie Marie, receive the light of Christ. Parents and godparents, this light is entrusted to you to be kept burning brightly. This child of yours has been enlightened by Christ. Callie is to walk always as a child of the light. May she keep the flame of faith alive in her heart, so that when the Lord comes, she may go out to meet him with all the saints in the heavenly kingdom. Callie, the Lord Jesus, may the deaf hear and the dumb speak. May soon touch your ears to hear his word, and your mouth to proclaim the praise and glory of God the Father. Amen. And let us pray. God the Father, through his Son, the Virgin Mary's child, has brought joy to all Christian mothers as they see the hope of eternal life shine upon their children. Lord, we ask your blessings upon Kayla, the mother of Callie. She now thanks God for the gift of her daughter. May she be one with her in thanking you forever in heaven. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. God is the giver of all life, human and divine. Lord, we ask your blessings upon Troy, the father of Callie. He and Kayla will be the first teachers of their child in the ways of faith. May they be also the best of teachers, bearing witness to the faith by what they say and do. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. My dear friends, it is a great joy and honor of mine to introduce to you the newest member of our Christian community, Callie Marie Pokalski. Please stand and let us come to the Lord this day, our God, who is our help, as we now offer our petitions and our prayers.
Because Christ is the light of the nations, we call on the church to carry this light to all people. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Since God loves all people, we seek world leaders who value each person's rights and freedoms. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Because mothers lead their children by example, we encourage women to model their lives on Mary, whose love and faith is overflowing. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Since all families face difficulties, we ask for God's help, comforting those with physical and mental ailments, as well as the very old and the very young. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Because we grieve the passing of our loved ones, we remember Henrietta Margis and her family, Tani Schmidt and Jim Michaels. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Because our Lord has promised a spirit, we ask him to breathe his life and love into the hearts of our young people who are being confirmed next weekend. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. We pray as well for Callie Marie, for her parents and godparents, that the light of Christ given to her through this gift of and grace of baptism might continue to burn brightly in her heart and home. We pray. Loving and gracious God, we gather here this day. We give you thanks for the gift of your Son, the Messiah, who is presented to us this day. Help us to take him into our lives and our arms so that we might hold you as mystery close to our hearts. Hear our petitions, answer them according to your will, for we ask them through Christ our Lord. We invite our children to bring their offering forward.
Please join in singing number 46, Beyond the Moon and Stars, number 46 in the Maroon Pew Hymnal or on the screens in front of you.
Thank you.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God and the Almighty Father. May the offering made with exaltation by your church be pleasing to you, O Lord, for you will that your only begotten Son be offered to you for the life of the world as the Lamb without blemish, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. And the Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for your co-eternal Son was presented on this day in the temple and revealed by the Spirit as the glory of Israel and the light of the nations. And so we too go forth, rejoicing to encounter your salvation, and with angels and saints praise you, as without end we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and John, our Bishop, with all the clergy and with all your people. Remember also our sisters and our brothers who have died in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen, amen, amen. Together we pray for our daily bread, as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but to deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ, for the kingdom. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. And the peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us share with each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those now called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Please join in singing number 587, "Christ Be Our Light," number 587.
Longing for light, we wait in darkness. Longing for truth, we turn to you. Make us your holy people, light for the world to see. Longing for peace, our world is troubled. Longing for hope, many despair. Your word alone has power to save us. Make us your living voice. Christ, be our light. Shine in our heart, shine through the darkness. Christ, our light, shine in your church, gathered today, longing for food, many are hungry. Longing for water, many still thirst. Make us your bread, broken for others, shared until all are fed. Christ be our light, shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Christ be our light, shine in your church, gathered today. Longing for shelter, many are homeless. Longing for warmth, many are cold. Make us your building, sheltering others, walls made of living stone.
Christ be our light, shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Christ be our light, shine in our church, gather today.
Many are gifts, many the people, many the hearts that yearn to belong. Let us be servants to one another, making your kingdom come.
Christ be our light, shine in our hearts, shine through the darkness. Christ be our light, shine in your church, gather today.
Thank you.
Let us pray. By these holy gifts which we have received, O Lord, bring your grace to perfection within us. And as you fulfilled Simeon's expectation that he would not see death until he had been privileged to welcome the Christ, so may we, going forth to meet the Lord, obtain the gift of eternal life through Christ our Lord. Amen. And the Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Before we go, I'd like to extend a personal thank you to all those who helped make our 23rd annual St. Mary's Foundation Gala such a huge success again this past Friday evening, to all those who spent this past week coming to help set up the decorating, the food preparation, the setting of the tables, the silent auction items, to all those who donated items for the silent auction and the live auction, as well as all of those of you who attended Friday evening. Thank you from the bottom of my heart for your participation in this great event each year. Secondly, this week I'm going to see a lot of Bishop Lavore. He's going to be here on Tuesday and Wednesday for Pastor Leader Days, and he's coming next Sunday for confirmation. So you know that I'm going to be on my best behavior this week. So because the bishop is here on Tuesday and Wednesday for Pastor Leader Days, please be mindful in the bulletin that the weekday masses for those 2 days has changed from the normal schedule. So please make sure you check that out in the bulletin if you're a regular daily mass attendee, that those times have changed for this week only. Also, next Sunday, the bishop will be here for confirmation. I oftentimes have people tell me, Father Steve, why didn't you tell me it was confirmation today? Because, you know, they don't want to sit through the whole liturgy. So I'm telling you, next Sunday is confirmation, okay? So the bishop is going to be here. So if you don't have any young people involved in confirmation this year, and if you don't want to sit through a liturgy that's a little bit longer than an hour, well, you might want to consider attending one of our other masses next weekend. And that, too, has changed. If you go Saturday night, that's always the same at 4:30. But next Sunday morning only, there'll be an 8:30 Mass. And I know all those of you who love 8:30 Mass are right now saying, yes, yeah? So next Sunday, you can come at 8:30, all right? So if you come at 9:30, you're going to be really, really late. But the good news is you'll be early for confirmation next Sunday. So please be mindful of that change next Sunday as well. Thirdly, I'd ask that you please remember in your prayers for the repose of the soul of Antoinette Schmidt. Her funeral service will be celebrated here at St. Mary's this coming Thursday at 11 a.m. Also, I regret to inform you of the death of Dr. Jim Michaels. He died down in Arizona. His funeral arrangements are still pending, but it's believed that his memorial mass will be celebrated in late spring, most likely the end of April. But I'd ask that you please keep clean Jim's wife, as well as Robert, which is Antoinette's husband, in your prayers as they grieve the loss of their spouse. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord. And may they rest in peace. Also, please join with me in thanking our children's choir for leading us in our song prayer. And my final announcement, I promise, tomorrow we celebrate the Feast of St. Blaise. So at the end of Mass, as soon as Tim starts playing here, I and the Eucharistic ministers will be made available for you to receive the blessing of throats. If you would like to receive that blessing, we invite you to come up at this time. There will be 2 Eucharistic ministers with candles for the blessing back by the baptismal font. So please use all of the Eucharistic ministers who are here for that blessing today. Our Mass is now ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And let us go forth, and as we go forward, singing City of God, number 385 in your maroon pew hymnal, or on the screens in front of you, number 385.